Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to Lightning Gaming. So in today's episode I'm gonna show you the ultimate sledgehammer bolt you can have in 7 days to die. Now guys, this sledgehammer bolt is so overpowered, you can do horde nights and you don't need the horde base at all. What's very important, it's really fun. You don't have to sit inside the horde base just knocking the zombies down easily or using any exploits to kill the zombies. You can run around in the wasteland and you can just kill them all with the sledgehammer by bashing their heads in. What can be more fun than that? Now guys, this is a day 248 horde, and as long as you have enough medkits with this bolt, you're gonna be able to survive the entire night. Cause as you can see guys, with the sledgehammer bolt you're gonna hit multiple zombies at once, killing them all very fast. And then also you're gonna be able to run super fast, they can't catch up to you. If you get into a tight corner, you're gonna be able to jump right over them and just run all the way to the back again and just circle around and start hitting them from the other side. So there's no way they can get you guys, there's no way they can kill you. As long as you have enough medkits with this bolt, nothing is impossible. Now guys, you can even go as far as go into a tier 5 POI and do the horde night in there and just run around in there knocking the zombies out. That is also fun to do by breaking stairs and stuff like that and hitting them with the sledgehammer. But yeah, whichever way suits you. And as you can see, I just like to run around and yeah, just bash them all in. I'll show you guys the bolt at the end of this video. I'll show you all the buffs you're gonna need, I'm gonna show you the perks you need and the best armor to go with this bolt. Let me just knock out these guys real quick. Yeah guys, cause the reason I like this bolt more than building any horde base guys is just it gets so boring, especially when you've been playing this game for a long time. It gets very boring just to sit in there and just knocking them out or shooting them as they run over your horde base. And yeah, I don't think anyone would like to do that. Now guys, you should try this out if you are 2 or 3 people online at the same time and you're playing with friends. It makes it even far more fun, because then zombies won't just all aggro on you like they're doing right now. You're gonna be able to eat them from all sides and you'll just be able to kill all the zombies. What's also nice, if you're more than one person, one can just focus on collecting all the loot bags while the other one draws the entire horde. So yeah guys, you must try it out, it's very OP. And the reason I chose the sledgehammer over the spears or the stun baton or anything like that is you are just able to do so much damage to a lot of zombies at once. I don't think there's another weapon that comes close to this except for the stun baton. You can knock a lot of them down. But with the sledgehammer you're gonna be able to kill a lot of them at once. So the sledgehammer by far is the best to do this method with. And another thing you'll notice guys, look at my stamina in the bottom left corner. You just will never run out of stamina with this bolt. It's so overpowered that you can just keep on swinging this sledgehammer, which usually takes a lot of stamina. You're gonna be able to keep swinging it and you won't run out of stamina at all. Now guys, the stuff you're gonna need is a little hard to get, but if you're endgame it shouldn't be a problem for you. So yeah, let's jump straight over to the bolt. Okay guys, so for the bolt, let me just go in my inventory. You're gonna use mega grass for extra speed. You're gonna get 50% extra running speed from that. Then steroids at another 10% running speed. That one is also very important. Then skullcrusher gives you a plus 50% melee damage. And then for our sledgehammer guys, as you can see, 104 damage, 173 with power attacks. And then let me show you my modifications real quick. You have to have all 4, so it's the red remover modification, structural brace mod, weighted head mod and the burning shaft mod. Now guys, it doesn't really matter so much which modifications you use, you can use whatever you want as long as you have 4. Now for our perks, we're gonna go with attributes, strength, and we're gonna go skullcrusher, begin fast, and then fortitude. Gonna go 10 out of 10, pain tolerance 5 out of 5, and then healing factor and rule 1 cardio. You're gonna max all three of those out. Then agility, you're gonna go 10 out of 10, and that is only for parkour. Because the parkour just works so nice when you get cornered with this build. It just helps you to jump straight over all the zombies. Then for the gear, guys, full biker set for maximum melee damage. Thank you so much for watching. Till next time.